In this video, we are discussing game theory by using graphical method. Here, we give a simple graphical method applicable to 2x n rectangular game. For a 2x n rectangular game, the payoff matrix of 2x n game will contain 2 rows and n columns. Here, we are going to see a 2x n game along with a problem. Now, we look at the problem. Consider the payoff matrix of player P1 as shown below and solve it optimally using graphical method. We have the payoff matrix of player P1. The player P1 has got 2 strategies and the player P2 has got 4 strategies. Now we need to find whether the game has got saddle point or not. For this, just find out the row minimum and column maximum and find out the max min value and min max value. Look at the first row. Minimum value is 15, that is the row minimum is 15. And in the second row, minimum value is 0, that is row minimum is 0. Among these 15 and 0, we have maximum value is 15. So, maximum I, minimum j, aij is equal to 15. In the same way, we find the column maximum. In the first column, we have the maximum value is 19. And in the second column, the maximum value is 20. In the third column, the maximum value is 17. In the fourth column, maximum value is 16. So, among these values, the minimum value is 16. So, minimum j, maximum I, aij is equal to 16. That is, here we obtain maximum I, minimum j, aij is equal to 15 and minimum j, maximum I, aij is equal to 16. So, maximum I, minimum j, aij not equal to minimum j, maximum aij. That is 16 is not equal to 15. So, there is no saddle point in this game. Thus, here we are following the mixed strategy. Let the mixed strategy of P1 be x equal to x1 minus x. Then, we are finding the expected payoff functions. E of x eta 1 is equal to 19x plus 0 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 19x. E of x eta 2 is equal to 15x plus 20 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 20 minus 5x. E of x eta 3 is equal to 17x plus 15 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 17x plus 15 minus 15x, which is equal to 15 plus 2x. And E of x eta 4 is equal to 16x plus 5 into 1 minus x, which is equal to 5 plus 11x. Then we will find the player 1's expected gain when x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. When x equal to 0, we obtain the values 0, 20, 15 and 5. When x is equal to 1, we get 19, 15, 17 and 16. Now we plot E against X in the domain 0 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 1. For the expected function eta E of X eta 1 is equal to 19X, we have when X equal to 0, we obtain 0 and X equal to 1, we get 19. So, we can draw the line and this line represents player P1's expected payoff function when P2 select first strategy. For the second expected function, we have E of x eta 2 is equal to 20 minus x. When x equal to 0, expected gain is 20 and when x equal to 1, expected gain is 15. So, we can plot the line. This line represents P1's expected payoff function when P2 select second strategy. From the third expected payoff function, 15 plus 2x, we obtain expected gain when x equal to 0 is 15 and x equal to 1 is 17. Now we can plot the line. This line represents P1's expected payoff function when P2 select third strategy. Also we have from the expected payoff function e of x eta 4 is equal to 5 plus 11x. We obtain the expected gain when x equal to 0 is 5 and when x equal to 1 is 16. Then we obtain this line. This line represents P1's expected payoff function when P2 select fourth strategy. Thus, the four lines represent the four expected payoff to P1. The continuous piecewise linear curve OBCD gives the least expectation for any value of x, 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. P1 must choose x so as to maximize his least expectation. Obviously, C is the point where the least expectation is the maximum. C is the intersection of the lines e of x eta 2 is equal to 20 minus 5x and e of x eta 4 is equal to 5 plus 11x. From this, we obtain the value of x, that is 20 minus 5x is equal to 5 plus 11x, which implies 15 is equal to 16x and then x is equal to 15 by 16. So, the optimal strategy for P1 is x0 is equal to 15 by 16, 1 by 16. And the value of game is v is equal to e of x0 eta 2, which is equal to e of x0 eta 4, which is equal to 20 minus 5 into 15 by 16, which is equal to 245 by 16. So, we obtain the value of game is 245 by 16. Now, to find the optimal strategy for P2, let y0 is equal to y1, y2, y3, y4, where y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus y4 is equal to 1. E of x0 eta 1 is equal to 19x, which is equal to 19 into 15 by 16, which is equal to 285 by 16. And E of x0 eta 2 is equal to 20 minus 5 into x, which is equal to 20 minus 5 into 15 by 16, equal to 245 by 16. E of x0 eta 3 is equal to 15 plus 2 into 15 by 16, which is equal to 270 by 16. E of x0 eta 4 is equal to 5 plus 11x, which is equal to 5 plus 11 into 15 by 16, which is equal to 245 by 16. Then we get e of x0 y0 is equal to 285 by 16 into y1 plus 245 by 16 into y2 plus 270 by 16 into y3 plus 245 by 16 into y4 is equal to 245 by 16. This implies 285 by 16 into y1 plus 270 by 16 into y3 plus 245 by 16 into y2 plus y4 is equal to 245 by 16. We know that y2 plus y4 is equal to 1 minus y1 minus y3. Thus we get 285 by 16 into y1 plus 270 by 16 into y3 plus 245 by 16 into 1 minus y1 minus y3 is equal to 245 by 16. We get 40 by 16 into y1 plus 25 by 16 into y3 is equal to 0. We know that y1 is greater than or equal to 0 and y3 is greater than or equal to 0. This implies y1 is equal to y3 is equal to 0. Hence, y0 is equal to 0, y2, 0, y4, which is equal to 0, y2, 0, 1 minus y2. Here, we obtain y1 is equal to y3 is equal to 0. So, we can make a 2 by 2 payoff matrix from the original problem. From that matrix, we get e of theta 1 y0 is equal to 15 y2 plus 16 y4, which is equal to 15 into y2 plus 16 into 1 minus y2, which is equal to 16 minus y2. And e of theta 2 y0 is equal to 20y2 plus 5y4, which is equal to 5 plus 15y2. Now, we can plot
E against y2 in the domain 0 less than or equal to y1 less than or equal to 1. This is the graph of E against y2 in the domain 0 less than or equal to y2 less than or equal to 1. In this curve, the curve ABC represents the maximum payoff to P1 for any value of y2. You must choose y2 so as to minimize this payoff. At the point B, we can minimize the payoff. Where B is the intersection of the two lines, E of eta 1 y0 is equal to 16 minus y2 and E of eta 2 y0 is equal to 5 plus 15 y2. So, we obtain 16 minus y2 is equal to 5 plus 15 y2, which is equal to y2 is equal to 11 by 16. Consequently, we get y4 is equal to 1 minus y2, which is equal to 1 minus 11 by 16. Then y4 is equal to 5 by 16. That is, the optimal strategy of P2 is y0 is equal to 0, 11 by 16, 0, 5 by 16. Thus, the optimum value of the game is 245 by 16. So, we obtain the solution.